of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Cougars. Welcome to SCE TV News for Wednesday, September 18th. I'm Wyatt Carr.
And I'm Audrey Brown. We are halfway through Mita Week on campus, and thank you to all the students who have participated so far. Today, we have more information about mitochondrial disease and why it is so important to find a cure.
Most parents dream that their children will do great things in life. However, for parents whose children who have mitochondrial disease, this dream is just that, a dream.
Mitochondrial disease is a deadly disease that is commonly found among children and young adults.
50% of children with mitochondrial disease die before the age of 10.
How do you feel about having a child with mito?
Having a child with mitochondrial disease, I feel very lost, alone. I feel very heartbroken and devastated. In the beginning, we knew nothing about the disease, and now that we learned more about it, it just breaks our hearts every day. Having a child with mitochondrial disease has changed our lives in a significant way. We're always at the doctor's offices, we're always in therapy appointments. He constantly gets sick, so we end up in the emergency room a lot. It's really hard for us as parents to watch your child sit there and scream and not know how to help them, for your child not to be able to tell you what hurts. It's sad that he watches other kids play and he never gets the chance to get up and do things with them because he's unable to walk or move around on his own. It's a really heartbreaking thing to watch your kids go through this and to not really even know much about the disease or what to expect. It's really killing us inside. We see life in a whole different way. We do things differently. We never get to really go out places because he constantly gets sick and we have to be careful who he's around. It's just a really devastating diagnosis.
The human body is made up of more than just bones and blood. Our bodies contain trillions of cells that make up every organ and tissue. Inside the cells are structures called mitochondria that provide the energy for the cell. However, mitochondrial disease prevents the mitochondria from producing enough energy to power the cell. Because of this, cells become sick and cannot provide energy for the rest of the body.
This leads to organ failure, the inability to walk or talk, or even fight off sicknesses. Even the common cold can be deadly. Mitochondria are the culprit of every age-related disease, from diabetes, blindness, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, liver disease, ALS, chronic fatigue, to many others. Therefore, if we can cure mitochondrial disease, we may be able to find cures to sicknesses affecting more than 50 million adults. Yet, many types of mitochondrial disease are so new that they are not mentioned in medical textbooks and literature. So mitochondrial disease research gets very little funding from the National Institute of Health or from anyone else. Researchers are not able to find a cure for mitochondrial disease without funding. Every 30 minutes, a child is born who will develop mitochondrial disease by the age 10. Unless you help.
a few ways to help in the fight against Mito disease. First, you can donate to the Money for Mito fundraiser. Look for the donation can in your Block 2 classroom. The Block 2 class with the most money wins a pizza party. Also, stop by the quad at lunch or visit room K115 to purchase a carnation for a friend. The flowers go out this Friday, and put a reminder in your phone to wear green this Friday to show our support for Mito disease research.
There is only one more week to purchase tickets to this year's homecoming dance. The big event is next Saturday, September 28th, on campus. Tickets are available at the finance office, but sales will end 1 week from today. The cost is now $40 with an ASB card and $50 without. Prices increase next week, so if you're planning on going, you need to get your tickets as soon as possible.
Every Wednesday, SCTV News is partnering with the special education teachers and students in room D110 for a weekly weather report. Here's what to expect for the rest of the week.
Good morning, viewers. My name is Yaw with weekly weather report. This week will be partly cloudy in the 70s. That's the weather report. I'd like to know, so I'll go so I get some.
Awesome.
All right.
Sending junky rhythms right down your block. We beat to rap, what key beat to lock, but I'm cool like that. 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 I'm cool.
We be the chocolates, taps on my raps. She innovates after sweet and cat naps. He at the
Cougars might be wandering into unauthorized areas during lunch. That's the main topic of this week's security update.
Hi, this is Drew.
And this is Elena.
And we're here for your another update of campus security.
So students must be downstairs during lunch at all times until the bell rings. And students are only allowed to go to the classroom if they have a destination spot.
We tell all of our students, and especially our parents, to drive no more faster than 5 miles per hour while you're on Steel Canyon campus. Also to our students, you need to use the main crosswalk when crossing from our campus to the front parking lot, just for your safety and for ours.
Also, for students who drive to school, make sure you have your parking permit. And for those who plan on driving to school, Start Smart will be September 18th at 6 p.m.
We're telling all of our students that when you go to the games on Friday, whether it's JV or varsity, if you go onto the home side, you have to have your ASB card with you in order to go to the game for free. If not, no cash is accepted. They are accepting credit card payments, or you can buy online. Now, when you go to the games, if you have a friend with you that is not a Steel Canyon student, you can go to the game with that friend, but you have to have a parent with you at all times during both games. If you happen to go to the visitor side, you will stay on the visitor side. You cannot come out and go to the Steel Canyon side. That is where you are for the rest of the night.
That's your campus security update. We'll see you next time. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Go Cougars.
Rah, rah, go Cougars. You say rah, rah, Cougars.
No, we both say rah, rah, Cougars, and you say, yeah!
Rah, rah, Cougars or rah, rah, go Cougars?
I think it's rah, rah, Cougars.
Rah, rah, Cougars, yeah!
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Yeah!
All Cougars who reserved a parking space have only one more day to customize their spot. If you missed the first chance to paint your parking space, Makeup Painting Day is this Saturday from 8 a.m. to noon in our front parking lot. This is your last chance to make your parking space your own, so see you here on Saturday morning.
Girls Golf has a match against Valhalla today. Girls Flag Football is home against Cathedral Catholic at 4. Freshman Football is home against St. Augustine at 5:15. And Girls Volleyball is home against Montgomery, freshman and JV at 4, and varsity at 6.
That's all the news we have for you today. Have a great week. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Cougar pride?
Get some.